Man, oh man, oh man, what's going on everybody? This is Gen716. Quick upload for you guys back here again. Before we start, hopefully you guys are staying safe, especially during these, especially during these trying times. Stay safe out there. But man, Rob Gronkowski going to the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, playing with Tom Brady on a one-year deal, $10 million. This is a big deal. For some reason, Rob, he decided he wants to play football again. The Patriots were willing to trade Gronk, and the Buccaneers got him. And this is huge for Tom Brady. Now, there have been rumors that O.J. Howard, that the Buccaneers, they've been looking to trade O.J. Howard somewhere. I kind of feel like O.J. Howard has had an unfair career with the Buccaneers. I think the dude has the potential to be the best tight end in all of football. But I think, just because playing in that Tampa Bay system, that air raid, that type of air it out system, he hasn't really had his fair share of opportunities. But Gronkowski, man, you bring in Gronk, you're bringing in Tom Brady's number one weapon, his favorite weapon to go to. And then you pair that up with Chris Godwin, Mike Evans. That is huge. That's really, really huge. Now, the question is, how much does Gronk have? Because we've seen during his last year, during that 2018 season, that, he didn't really show it until like the end of the season, right? This is the guy that's dealt with so many injuries, whether if it's knee injuries, whether if it's foot injuries, whether if it's his elbow, his hand. He's dealt with so many injuries, concussions. So there's going to be a question of, is he going to bring it, right? How much does he have left? Does he still play like a top five tight end in the league? We all know he doesn't play like a top two or top three tight end, but does he play like a top five, top 10 tight end? That's a question we're definitely going to find out, especially if we have a 2020 season. But I'm sure of this. Gronkowski, he's one of the best blocking tight ends we've ever seen, if not the best blocking tight end of all time. I'm pretty sure that Gronkowski, he's been working out a lot. He's been having fun. We've been seeing him in Orchard Park. We've been seeing him in Williamsville, if you're from the area of Buffalo. But, Gronk, he's been living his best lives. But, man, he's still been working on the game of football. I think from the blocking standpoint, he's going to be fine in that standpoint. But as far as route running, as far as speed and stuff like that, as far as strength, as far as, most importantly, if he can stay healthy, that's just something that we're going to have to find out about. Is he going to have that Jason Witten type of impact where you get Jason Witten, he's not the same player he was when he was in his early 30s or in his 20s with the Cowboys. But still, he unretired. He made an impact for the Cowboys, right? He still was a really good route runner. He was an okay blocker, but still a really good route runner. Still can catch the football, but just didn't have that same oomph. Just didn't have that same type of pop that he did with the Cowboys early in his career. I feel like Gronk will probably have that. But still, as far as leadership goes, as far as just bringing the fun to the locker room, I think Gronk would definitely be that spark plug that the Tampa Bay Buccaneers might need. And most importantly for Tom Brady, that's your number one target. The chemistry. The chemistry is already there. And again, pairing him up with Mike Evans and Chris Godwin, arguably the best receiving duo in football, the Buccaneers looks like they're going to be a scary team going into the 2020 season. And I'm just excited to see it. So anyway, guys, hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. Again, I know I've been, taking some time off a little bit lately, but I am back now. And especially with this Gronk news, again, I'm a Bills fan, so I'm kind of glad that Gronk's out of here. He's out of the AFC East. But, man, Tampa Bay, you guys got to be excited for the future. Man, it's going to be a crazy ride going into 2020. The Gronk is back.